What can you tell me about the guy with the wings?
Other than he's a psychopath dressed like a demon? Nothing.
You're messing with things you don't understand.
I did the Vulture many years ago. He was one of Spider-Man's first villains. And I like the idea of somebody who is not very muscular, but who has the ability to fly and is strong enough to do what has to be done.
The Vulture was this weird sort of like scrawny old dude with like weird white hair and this green leotard.
And the idea of this middle-aged Vulture that had never, as far as I know, been a villain like that before.
He obviously wasn't going to translate too well to a live-action movie in 2017. So what we did is take a step back and then see how can we make him feel scarier.
The idea that you would build a suit to look like a vulture is very showboaty. But if we can come up with a good reason for him to need a wingsuit, then I think it's working backwards from there. Like, why would you have this?
I got eyes on the convoy, dropping down. Looks like they got some good stuff here.
We kind of had the scavenging idea early on in development, and we started kind of trying to figure out what villain could work well into that.
Everything should be informed by, like, a logic. Why is this real? You know, why do you need to fly up to a certain height? If you fly up to a certain height, would you need a helmet? You know, do you need something for when there's no oxygen, when you get to sort of high altitude levels? Do you have to stay warm? Is this military technology, or is it this hacked sort of thing that the Tinkerers built? How much personal embellishments would you put on this if it was basically custom made for you? So I think you get to have a lot of fun with why it looks the way it looks.
One of the things that knocked me out about being the Vulture was the amazing artistry of the Vulture suit. It was extraordinary, down to tiny little nuts and bolts. Even the mechanics of it, I was just knocked out by how talented those people were.
This isn't some small backpack that he straps on and wings pop out of it. This is way more like an aircraft that he straps into.
You have a bad guy who's wearing a 30-foot wingspan vulture armor made out of all kinds of Chitauri tech that he stole from the Avengers.
The vulture look is an intense look, and just wearing the costume makes you feel really physically imposing.
Well, he has the scariest wings you've ever seen. They're blades. It's like a million knives right in your face. And it's great to have Spider-Man be fighting someone who is also aerial.
We wanted him to be really dangerous because Spider-Man is one of the greatest superheroes of all time.
That thing hasn't even touched me yet!
True.
Then again, wasn't really trying to.
And Michael Keaton is, like, incredible in this movie.
Kevin and I, from the very beginning, only saw this part as Michael Keaton.
The world's changing.
It's time we change, too.
This is one of those cliche Hollywood stories where we're like, well, you know, the best person to get to play the role of the Vulture would be Michael Keaton, but we were told that the schedule just wouldn't work out. Then we got a call back from his team saying, actually, if you guys are still interested, we're like, are we still interested? Of course.
I learned online that he was the frontrunner, then rang John and asked him if it was true, and he said, yeah, it's true, it's gonna happen. And we both had that moment of like, this is insane.
Bingo.
You can't say enough about Keaton if you look at what he's done, you know, a couple years ago to what he was doing back when we were all looking for who were the guys we turned to for this kind of new American naturalism, to obviously spanning not just our universe, but other universes.
Yeah.
Business is good.
When you have actors like Michael Keaton playing the Vulture, you're gonna get a very three-dimensional look at that role.
I can't afford that.
So you're going to root for him as much as you want to root against him.
I thought this was the anti-gravity gun.
No, that's that one.
It was a very enlightening experience getting to work that closely with someone whose attention to detail is just microscopic. Like, I think I caught him counting some steps at one point.
Now you're the shocker.
Michael has a very special quality. He is really scary. Every time we showed that moment, the audience would be like,
he must be Peter.
We basically shot the most intense scene of the whole movie the first time I'd met him. The whole scene plays through a mirror.
Good old Spider-Man.
And he was so intimidating, it required no acting on my behalf because I'm just meant to be terrified. There is no one who could play that role better than he could.
You're welcome.
To me, sort of laying all that groundwork, making sure that it has legs just beyond some sort of like villain of the week plot is really important.
I have to go home, Pete.
I'm trying to save you!
When you consider the size of this, how it's all interconnected with characters' histories and introduction of new characters. It's crazy. It's unbelievable.
That is a first unit picture wrap on Michael Keaton.
Thanks, everybody. It's
so
fun.
So good. The Vulture!